road should be a monster of some sort.
You're only limited by your imagination and your pocketbook.
And you'll go sometimes 6 or 8 feet underwater before you come out.
Mileage is about one chicken for every 10 miles.
She's the American monster. I'd like to fit her in a garage someday.
Join us now on a special romping, stomping road trip. We're looking for monsters, the homemade kind, and the folks who rip, grind, and burn them. We're busting through the garage and landing wheels up in your own backyard. This week, the Monster Garage is leaving Long Beach and heading to the hills. Jesse James and his band of Maverick mechanics aren't the only ones up to monster-making mischief. So we'll challenge two teams to do the Monster Mash on their own turf. And we'll cross the country to meet some normal folks and their monstrous machines. Rick Dobbertin's neighbors may think he's an astronaut, especially when a giant gleaming spaceship-like monster rolls out of the garage. The Dobbertin Surface Orbiter, 17,000 pounds of aluminum and stainless steel, able to navigate the roughest turf and the highest surf. But this amphibian began its life as a humble milk tanker.
I like to look at something, not what it is, but what it could be. So a milk tanker seemed like an obvious starting point because it's stainless steel, so it'll hold up to the saltwater corrosion problems. And I figured if it'd hold 30,000 pounds of milk inside, it would damn well keep the water out.
Rick spent years cutting, welding, and fabricating. Then he built a high-tech cockpit for his dream machine.
The left side is steering wheel, turns the front wheels, and the gauges for land use. This side turns the rear rudder and the gauges for the sea part of the trip.
With his task complete, Rick set off on a 2-year adventure. Heading to South America, the orbiter crossed long stretches of open ocean.
It's bottom heavy, so there's no way it would ever roll over.
And to keep an eye on his submerged drive shaft, Rick cut a window in the bottom.
I've seen fish dart out of the way, I've seen all kinds of stuff, but I never got any leaks.
Rick's voyage covered 33,000 miles in 28 countries. He survived a rickety bridge crossing in Costa Rica, was seized by Colombian gorillas, who just wanted their picture taken with the orbiter, and his monster became the first car to transit the Panama Canal.
This is just to say I did it, and now I can say I did it because I did it.
It's day one at 50.